The Musicians of Bremen. There was once a donkey who lived with a farmer. The donkey had worked hard for many years in the fields. Now he was old and had become too weak to work and carry the heavy loads he once did. The farmer didn't want him any longer, for what use was it keeping a donkey who couldn't work and earn him money? So the donkey decided to run away. He had heard about a town called Bremen. In Bremen there lived lots of musicians. "That's it," decided the donkey. "I will travel to Bremen and become a musician. I'll play the flute. I will be sure to have a good life there." With that, the donkey set off on his journey. On his way, the donkey passed a sad-looking dog who was sitting by the roadside, out of breath and panting. "Are you all right?" asked the donkey. "What's the matter?" "My master doesn't want me any longer," answered the old dog. "I used to be a hunting dog, but I am too old and tired now to chase after the foxes." "Don't worry about that," said the donkey. "I'm on my way to Bremen to become a musician. I'm going to play the flute. You should come too. You could play the drum." The dog agreed, and the two of them carried on along the path to Bremen. Soon after, they passed a cat who was sitting all by himself looking lost. "What's wrong, old cat?" they asked. "My master doesn't want me anymore," said the cat. "I used to chase all of the mice out of the farmhouse, but now I am old and tired and the mice are too fast for me. I can no longer catch them as I once did." "Don't be sad," said the donkey. "We're going to Bremen to become musicians. I'm going to play the flute and the dog is going to play the drum. You understand music, so you could be a musician too." "Great idea," cried the cat. "I'll come with you." So the donkey, the dog, and the cat continued along the path to Bremen. They hadn't gone far when they came across a cockerel at the side of the road. He was crowing sadly. "What's up with you, cockerel?" they asked. "My master doesn't want me anymore," replied the bird. "I used to wake him up at the same time every morning, but I am old and tired, and sometimes I forget to crow in the morning. I heard my master say that he wants to turn me into soup." "Don't worry," said the donkey. "We're all on our way to Bremen to become musicians. You have a fine voice. Why don't you come along with us? You could sing." "Oh, I love singing," remarked the cockerel. "I'll come." So the donkey, the dog, the cat, and the cockerel continued along the path to Bremen. It was a long way to Bremen, and the path was very long. Soon it was night time, and the animals lay down for a rest. They were tired and hungry, and it was very cold. "I can see something," crowed the cockerel. "Look!" He nodded in the direction of a house with a bright light in the window and a smoking chimney. "Maybe we'll find something to eat there, and I'm sure we'll be warmer and more comfortable." The other animals agreed, and they headed over to the house. When the animals got to the house, they saw five thieves gathered inside. The thieves were having a feast with lots of food and drink. In the corner of the room, there were comfortable beds. "We must get inside," said the donkey. "We need to feast on that food and sleep on those comfortable beds." The animals thought up a plan. They were musicians after all, so they would sing for their supper. They gathered together at the open window. The donkey brayed, the dog barked, the cat meowed, and the cockerel crowed. Then they clambered through the open window. The thieves were frightened by all the noise, and, thinking that some horrible monster must be in the house, they ran away as fast as they could. "Well," said the donkey, "our first concert seems to have gone very well." And the animals began to feast on the delicious food before settling down on the comfortable beds and going to sleep. Out in the forest, in the dark night, the leader of the gang of thieves looked back at the house and noticed that there was no longer a light burning. He turned to the others and said, "Hey, wait a minute. That couldn't have been a monster back there. There is no such thing as monsters. We shouldn't have let ourselves get so scared. I'm going to go back and kill whatever I find." He ran back to the house and crept quietly inside. It was dark and quiet inside. The thief saw the glowing eyes of the cat and by mistake thought that they must be burning coals. So he held his match next to them, thinking that he could light it. The cat, however, did not understand what the thief meant to do, so he flew at him, scratching him with his claws. The thief ran towards the door, but the dog was lying there sleeping. Upon being woken so suddenly, the dog bit the thief on the leg. The donkey woke up now too and kicked at the thief with his back legs. The cockerel began crowing and making a terrific noise. "Ah, monster, monster!" screamed the thief and fled as fast as he could. The thieves never dared set foot in that part of the wood or in the little house again. The animals, on the other hand, were very happy in the little house. They could find food in the wood and sleep in the comfortable beds. There was really no need for them to travel to Bremen anymore. They lived together happily in the little house for the rest of their days.